Hello students, in this video we are going to study about BPSK technique, that is binary phase shift keying. Basically, phase shift keying is the digital modulation technique where the phase angle of the carrier signal is going to be changed according to the information bits. So the information bit can be 1 or 0, and based on this the phase angle of the carrier signal is going to be changed. Here in this waveform it is shown that for logic 1 and for logic 0 there is a phase difference of 180 degree. So in this video we will go through the representation of BPSK signal, and followed with that what is the basis function, and based on the basis function how to represent a signal. Then up to the constellation diagram we are going to study. Then followed with the next video, we will have a look over the BPSK transmitter and the receiver circuit. Then the probability of error that can occur in BPSK system, BPSK digital modulation system, that we will study. So we are going to see all these mathematical terms one by one. So in binary PSK, there are two information bits are transmitted, the bit 1 and bit 0. These are the message signal. So the bit 1 is represented by the signal S1 of t, and bit 0 is represented by the signal S2 of t. So S1 of t is under root 2 eb divided by tb into cosine of 2 pi fct, and S2 of t is the negative value of the signal. So basically the carrier signal which carries the information bits we considered in every modulation technique is C of t is equal to A into cosine of 2 pi fct plus phi. For the information bit 1, that S of t, the carrier is as it is and the phase angle is taken as 0, and to transmit the information bit 0, S2 of t, where the carrier signal phase angle is kept 180 degree phi. So we know A cosine of 2 pi fct plus phi is minus A cosine of 2 pi fct. So the negative term. A cos 2 pi fct is a representation of the symbol 1, and minus A cos 2 pi fct is the representation of symbol 0. Under the interval of 0 less than or equal to t less than or equal to tb. Tb is the bit duration. So bit duration is generally represented with the integer multiples. So and in digital modulation we represent that amplitude in terms of energy. So energy here is given as in the transmitted signal energy per bit, that is given as eb is equal to integral 0 to tb s1 square. Let us integrate the first signal under the interval of 0 to tb. So energy of the signal is obtained by integrating the square of the signal under the bit duration. So here S1 of t is A cos 2 pi fct. So substituting here we get A square cosine square 2 pi fct into dt. And taking A square outside the constant value, we know the cos square theta is equal to 1 plus cos 2 theta divided by 2. 1 plus cos 2 theta divided by 2. So applying this here we get 1 plus cos 4 pi fct divided by 2, and taking 2 outside, integrating 1 and integrating cos 4 pi fct. So integration of cosine 4 pi fct is 0, and integration of dt is resulting as t under the interval 0 to tb, and substituting here we get a square into a square divided by 2 into tb minus 0. So it is a square tb divided by 2. So that is what written here. So the energy of the bit duration is a square into tb divided by 2. And in terms of amplitude, and rewriting this equation, so a square, rewriting this equation is a is equal to under root 2 into eb divided by tb. So this is what mentioned here. So the signal S1 of t is under root 2 eb divided by tb cosine 2 pi fct, and for the bit 0 S2 of t is minus under root 2 eb divided by tb cosine 2 pi fct. So this is the signal representation, and we need to find the basis function in modulation. In every modulation we find the basis function, and by using Gram-Schmidt orthogonalization procedure we can calculate the basis function. Here n is basis function and m is number of signals transmitted, and the condition is n less than or equal to m. So the first basis function is calculated as dividing the signal, the first signal s1 of t by under root eb. So we get here as s1 of t is written here under root eb, and root eb is getting cancelled. So we are getting the first basis function as under root 2 divided by tb cosine 2 pi fct in the bit duration 0 to tb. And we know that s2 of t is negative of s1 of t. And according to Gram-Schmidt orthogonalization procedure and pi 2 of t, while calculating based on this method, we will be getting 0. And we use one basis function to represent s1 of t and s2 of t, right? So here n is equal to 1, m is equal to 2. So the signal s1 of t can be represented. What is s1 of t? It is root eb divided by tb cosine 2 pi fct. So taking under root eb outside, right, under root eb outside, this can be written as under root eb into pi 1 of t in the bit duration, and signal 2 is represented as minus under root eb pi 1 of t. So this is the standard signal representation of BPSK signals, and this is the one dimensional modulation. Let's see how to find a constellation point. So in general, the constellation point is represented as integral of the interval with 0 to tb, that is si of t into pi j of t. And I value varies from 1 to m, j value varies from 1 to n. N is the basis function and m is number of signals that is transmitted. So in this context, we have two signals. So m is equal to 2 and the basis function pi 1 of t. So n is equal to 1. So let us substitute. So I value 1 and 2 and j value here is 1. So substituting these I and j here in the constellation point equation, s11 and integral of s1 of t, I value is 1 and j value pi j of t, that is pi 1 of t, and substitute s1 of t. S1 of t is what? So s1 of t is under root eb pi 1 of t, right? That's what here written, and into pi 1 of t, which gives us pi 1 square of t. Also this basis function is of unit energy signal, where that is the integral of the basis function, the energy of the basis function is into dt is equal to 1. So that's what written here. S sub 11 is given as under root eb. By the same way, now substituting I is equal to 2 and j is equal to 1, we get S sub 21 is minus under root eb. So these are the constellation point. These are the constellation point where the received signals are going to be mapped with these energy levels. So here the constellation diagram is shown. We know this is a one-dimensional modulation where n is equal to 1. That is, we are having only one basis function. So the basis function is represented here, and we have a threshold point. Threshold point, we consider the threshold value, the decision boundary is 0, and from 0 to infinity, whatever the values in this region, we take the region 1, z1 and region 2, z2. So whatever the value, so the values from 0 to infinity in this region are going to be mapped to under root eb. And the values from 0 to minus infinity in this region are going to be mapped to the energy minus under root eb. So under root eb is representing logic 1, and under root minus eb is the representation of logic 0. So this is how the signals, the message signals, let's say zeros and ones are mapped, logic 1 and logic 0 are mapped in one dimensional way. At the receiver side, we are having a decision circuit. So based on this threshold range, if the received signal is greater than zero, then the information is extracted as one. So then the information is extracted as one, and if the received signal is less than zero, then the information is extracted as zero. And this is how the signal S1 of t is represented as under root AB into the basis function pi 1 of t. And the signal to represent, this is logic 1 and this is to logic 0, S2 of t in BPSK is given as minus under root AB pi 1 of t. So this pi 1 of t basis functions are meaning it has a one dimensional modulation. So in the next video, we will see the transmitter and the receiver structure of the BPSK modulation. Thank you.